two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. We're sure glad to see you today. John Fix and I recently went to a flea market, and while there were more vendors than in the past and a fair amount of tools, there just wasn't much quality there. But we were able to score a couple of nice different tools, and we're going to show you those today and also restore them. So let's get on down to the shop.
Well, I went to the flea market today, and even though it was better than it has been the last few months, there just wasn't a lot of tools that really interested me. There was more tools there than I've seen in a while, but nothing really worth getting. But I did pick up a couple of items, and one was this little pair of Pexto shears. I just like the little size. You can see the Pexto name on it. It'll clean up and show real well, and I thought, heck, that would be fun to put together, and also to have as a user tool around the shop. Sometimes you just need to do something small rather than get out the big ones. Get to use the cute little ones. I don't know if that was all one color or darkened down here or what, but we'll make them look nice. And by the way, I got it for $2, so wasn't too hard to pass up. I mean, it wasn't too hard not to pass. What do I mean? It was hard not to buy them, and I did buy them. The second item, I kind of went out of my area, and I bought this food press. Just thought it was, it's called a King Seamless Cup Press. And you can see here, it's solid steel all the way through, and of course quite rusted. You just put your item in the basket here and press it together, and I guess to take a piece of fruit or vegetable that you need the juice from and squeeze it and make it happen. I'm not that good of a cook where I get involved in that, but it does. Looks like this part will come out. I'll have to work with it a little bit. I'll be able to get that out. And I'm going to clean this up. I think it just would be a nice little item. Paid $3 for it. You can't beat that either. It's got a name here, too. It's C-I-N apostrophe T-I, which would be Cincinnati Galv, G-A-L-V. Gee, I can't make that out. Cincinnati Galv. I'll figure that out when I get it cleaned up, and I can read it down here where it does say King Seamless Cup Press. Thought it would be an interesting item, something different to do, so I'm going to clean this up and make it nice and see what I got. Well, here we are after Evapo Rust. Certainly did its job. The rust is gone. The little hardware seems to be in good shape. So the next step will be to go to the wire brush to get it cleaned up and determine the steps to take from there. So here's the food press after the bath in Evapo Rust. Looks like this was galvanized, and of course a lot of it's completely worn off. It's going to be a little difficult to get inside here to do the cleaning, but we're going to have to polish all this metal. And I did do a little test area here with a wire brush to see how it's going to do, and I think the wire brushing should do a lot for this, for the basket here. And the whole rest of it, you can see after the evaporation, of course the rust is gone, but the metal's completely discolored because it's eating away all the galvanizing. So this will head for the wire brush. We'll see what we get after that. Well, we can get a look at these little shears after wire brushing. Now you can see a lot of flaws that you couldn't see on this part that had just been run through the evaporust, but not clean. But you can see now lots of scarring, just rough machining, scrapes and so forth all over here. And of course, inside here, that's got a big casting mark all the way around. And it's, of course, not cleaned yet in there. I'm going to have to get in with a wire brush inside here. So we got a lot of work to do to get this finished up. Well, here's a progress report on the two tools we're restoring. A little pair of Pexto shears. Here it is after some pretty heavy wire brushing. And here it is after sanding and then finishing belt. Getting where I want it to be, so that's where we are on that. The food press. Here's the basket that was in there. This was galvanized. And I've just been, you know, the only way to make this completely rust-proof is to give it some sort of coating, which I don't have the ability to do. I haven't done any of that. And I thought about waxing it. I guess I can wax it to preserve it, but I'm scared of getting wax in all these little holes. And not too sure about getting it out, so I'll have to do a little experimenting to work on that. But it sure did clean up nice. The body of it itself, once I got it all wire brushed, it did clean it up fairly well. But here's the problem. Look how this was made. Look at that rough, rough grind and casting mark on here. Really sad. Really a shame. I just can't really own anything that looks like that and tell everybody I restored it. So here's what I did on the other side to get me where I want to be. Let me get this closed. Now you can see what some nice sanding will do. Got all those rough marks off down the side here, all around here. And I think it'll look a lot nicer finished once I get that done compared to this side over here, which is just really rough. How somebody could make something like that, I don't know. But anyway, we could keep working on it. I think I'm going to go ahead and sand down the handles here to get, because they've got a lot of pitting and rough marks on it. So I'll put my sandpaper to use and try to get everything looking like I've done over here on this side. Well, the flea market restorations are done. The first one I'm going to show you is this sweet little pair of Pexto shears. And while I have some Pexto shears already, the smallest one I have is 12 inches. This comes in at 7 inches. And I thought it would be handy to for small projects around the shop. I completely sanded it. There was a lot of pitting on here, and of course there was some rust. And polished it with my fine finishing belt to give it a nice luster, a nice shine. I thought about doing the handles either in a gun blue or painting them like I've done my other shears, but this one just, it looked right at this point. It looks good with a nice, shiny, silvery finish. You can see the Pexto name very clearly on here. Pexto, made in USA, model number 82. So, all around the edges, the handles. I had a question from somebody about how hard it was to get to the inside of the handles. And here's what I do. When I've got a sanding belt that's broken or near the end of life, I just take it and cut it where I can insert it in the handles and mount this in the vise and pull this back and forth in the handles, inside all the way around. And then I finish it off with, I've got one of these surface conditioning belts that was, again, getting pretty worn down, this one being a coarse one. And I can put that inside and slide it back and forth and to get it, you know, a little better finish inside the handles here. It's hard to get to, and I certainly can't get the finish as nice as I do on the outside, but I can get it looking good with that method. So that's the method I use to get items like this finished where you've got difficult areas to get to. The next item on my list was this nice food press. And I had to do a little research on this. First of all, I found out this company was started by five brothers in 1905. They put up $20,000 total. And they were really basically a galvanizing company. That's where you see the Cincinnati Galvanizing Company. And the first item that they made were barrel rings, which were the metal rings that went around wooden barrels. And then they came up with a galvanized ring so they wouldn't rust. And they made that for many years. And then they got into making what we could call tin cans, which were a galvanized metal cans. And that became their main business. But, and you know, for food cans. But after a while, they came up with they invented a seamless can. You know, the first ones had a seam around the bottom and so forth. Now the bottoms are formed on the cans. And that was, you know, a great product for them. And they used that patent to come, that idea to come up with this basket, which was a seamless basket. Now this item, I called it a food press. In fact, it's called King Seamless Cup Press. And that's the seamless cup that's on here. And but this is made wrought iron, cast iron. And then the basket's made out of a steel and galvanized. And it's still, after cleaning, after all those years, we were able to shine it and clean it, get it looking good. And I had to really get, in fact, there's a little cup, how it comes out and how it looks. Yeah, the little press plate on here, which had to be quite strong. And what this was done, it's called a ricer. Now, I didn't know what a ricer was. I had to go to somebody who cooks to tell me. Basically, with a ricer, you can put raw potatoes in here, and then you press it out, and they come out in small little pellets. And one of the big uses is making potato pancakes, and which I haven't had for quite a while, which are very good. I'm going to have to try to get a hold of some. Maybe we can make the ingredients with this press. And you can take a cooked potato and put it in here. Put this back together. And then you press it, and it just... For making mashed potatoes, for the cooked potato, for the raw potatoes, use it as a ricer to make the little potato pellets that look like rice. And then other vegetables and fruits you can do if you want to extract the juices from them. It's quite strong. You can do that. This was made, from the best I can tell, around the early 1930s. And I see quite a few of them for sale on the internet. I didn't realize... how many there were, but a lot of them. But after a while, they started making this out of a form metal, a stamped metal piece, which they formed for the handles and so forth. But this one was made out of a cast iron. And, of course, if you remember the shape, the condition, it was really pitted and bad. And the rough grind on it, really was very poorly made. So you smooth those out, the handles here, and the rim around here that holds the cup and all the parts. So we got it nice looking. We got it really cleaned up, really in usable condition. I'll have to find someone to test it out for me. I'm a little bit in the kitchen, but I'm not into exotics. But just a different item in your regular tools. So, and I bought them together, so I thought I would finish them together. We ended up with two nice projects, both usable products, one a kitchen tool and one a shop tool. Let me give a little test of the shop tool. Somebody said, I don't really test my products. Well, I do test them, but I don't usually put it on air. In this case, I'll get some sheet metal. And it's amazing. All I did was clean these up, polish them up. I didn't do any sharpening on them. Cuts as good as new. Bam. Here we go. Anyway, that's my shears. There's my press. Thanks for watching my video.